Hey, what's up everyone? It's David here. I've got the SkyQ here again, and this time I'm going to show how to use the 3D function if you've got a 3D TV, which is also a 4K TV as well, as there is a drawback on the 4K 3D version of TV. Well, this one's a Panasonic, but what it is basically, if you've got it set to 4K resolution, your 3D function will not work. So what will happen is, if I go over down to Sky Cinema, and I go on to genre, and then I go down to, there it is, 3D. The library has gotten a little bit slightly smaller recently, not as big as it was, but you know, it might be extended, I don't know, but a lot of Disney titles have left. So just click on here, Shrek Forever and After. Then click, should be able to just watch, continue, and see how you notice it says in the split screen. So no matter what you do on your Sky, sorry, on your TV function, so I'm going to go on to my actual settings for the 3D function, and you can see here it's got 3D settings. So I think, oh okay, but I've got nothing to click on. It doesn't seem to work. Unlike the Xbox One, where it will automatically switch to the 3D function on the resolution, the SkyQ box does not have that function. So what you need to do is, it's a bit of a downgrade, but again, there is no governing technology at the moment that allows you to watch 3D. Yeah, the 3D format in 4K. So you have to go to settings, go down to setup, go down to audio visual, where it says here I've got it to set to 2160p and 10-bit. That's no good. You have to go down to 1080p. I know it's a bummer, but you know, it is what it is. And then you go over to go back to your library here, cinema, and then yeah, go back to genre, 3D again. Let's download a new one. So let's go for that one and go for all formats. It's got UHD, 3D, HD, and the standard. So we want to go for the 3D. You can see that there is more information in there, as it's over twice the size of the high definition version. So I know it's just let's download that. And once again, I'll have to go back to my menu and go to picture, scroll down to 3D settings, which is right here. And see there, that's now highlighted. So that now work. So you've got original, you've got side-by-side 3D, and you've got top-to-bottom bottom 3D, and you've got 2D to 3D. So that converts any image from a 2D to a 3D, which is kind of cool. But, you know, obviously, not everyone wanted 3D, so that's why 3D TVs end up dying out in the end. You can still get 3D projectors, but anyway, how Sky uses theirs is it's a side-by-side, and you need to convert that to the 3D. So by pressing that one there, side by side 3D, and unfortunately what happens is with this, it yeah, as you can see there, it's now made it unreadable because of the program. But if I press play, it's now worked itself out, as you can see, because it had 2D, two images side by side. So I have to put on the remote, sorry, the 3D glasses. they're on. Don't know if it'll show it or not. Probably won't. Yeah, if there was a way to take these off so I could put it through the lens, that might work better. But anyway, yeah, that concludes it. So that's obviously now the 3D format. But again, if I want to convert the 3D back to the conventional 2D to I got adjustments on 3D. Adjustment effect. So I can increase the effect or decrease the effect. That's quite interesting. So the comfort level of each person depends on the 3D settings of the content. Please stop using 3D immediately if you feel tired. But one of the obviously one of the issues with 3D was the fact that people were wearing the glasses and they were looking around, and because the 3D glasses basically are constantly turning off and on, off and on, off and on, basically like lenses, it just keeps closing and open, closing and open, and closing and open, like how your eyes operate, your eyelids. That made people sick, especially when they looked around at other things, they look at the screen. So people were complaining about 3D obviously making them sick, but anyway. So I'll just go down to 2D to 3D, so that converts any 2D image to a 3D option. As you can see, it looks blurred at the moment, but obviously if you wear the glasses, oh my god, this 3D is fantastic. Actually, it looks like they're shooting at us. That was the A-Team, which I really would like to see that in 3D, but they never released the A-Team in 3D, unfortunately. They referenced it, but they never showed it. Yeah, see? Oh, there you go! I spy my little ass only beginning with 3. D? You got it. just being bonkers. Some people call me bonkers. Some people say I'm insane. See what I mean? So, if I go over to anything else, now that I've actually that. Oh, it's really bad. So what this does is, because I have used the 3D conversion, anything that's not 3D will be converted to 3D. So just trying to think of something. Back to the Future. I wonder what that looks like in 3D. Yeah. That might not run because it's UHD. UHD content will not run on a resolution lower than UHD. Like you do. Because it's going to be queued. So, got here. Scooby-Doo. Oh my god, I loved this film when I was a kid. Why isn't that in 3D? Okay, let's watch that. We love you, Scooby-Doo. Scooby, Dooby, Doo! There's advertisement. Sorry, I have to just put the glasses on myself. Oh my god, this is incredible. This is absolutely amazing. Why the hell did they ever kill 3D TVs? Yeah. Just wind it to a bit. Hopefully, I don't end up getting. Ooh. Good, huh? I wonder if the 3D function still. Yeah. You can still watch it even if you have one eye. Unfortunately, some people actually do have one eye, so, you know. Still good that at least you don't need the two. What's it called? The actual the red and blue glasses. 3D. Yeah, that one there. I think that only worked if you had both working eyes, which is a bit unfortunate because I actually had a friend that. Obviously, well, I have a friend that's only got eyesight in one eye, and yeah, he said he could never really experience it. So, don't know if he ever did the actual 3D glasses on the TV, but yeah. Anyway, so that concludes the video. Obviously, this is showing you how to get your 3D function to work on your SkyQ if you've got a 3D enabled display. So, yeah. So thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. If you like this video, please click the like. That would help me out a lot as YouTube's algorithms work. So it will basically show more content online, help my channel out. Also, you know, it will also show things that you've liked previously, and it will characterize things for you to watch as well. So, you know, hopefully everyone benefits from it. But, you know, yeah. So, see you later. Bye for now.